At the Richmond Air Force Base, two gifts from the sky in one day. Rain this morning and much-needed help from Japan's Self-Defence Force. Two C-130 Hercules transport planes touching down this afternoon on board a team of 80 military personnel.
The additional C-130s that the Japanese are bringing will be vital in helping us out.
These aircraft will help transport people and equipment needed to battle fires and recovery efforts, working side by side with the ADF.
It's a true reflection of friends supporting each other in crisis.
Japan didn't just send its people on board emergency relief supplies, including face masks.
A mid-flight emergency quickly led to one on the ground as a troubled plane dropped jet fuel onto a school playground in the US. Paramedics treated 20 children and 11 adults for minor injuries. The Delta flight had not long taken off from the airport in Los Angeles, bound for China, when it turned around and dropped fuel to make an emergency landing.
An explosive report has revealed a trainee air traffic controller was responsible for a near collision between two Qantas planes. The Melbourne-bound A330 was cleared for takeoff at Sydney Airport as an incoming Boeing 737 from Brisbane was seconds away from landing. There was just 152 metres between the jets, triggering the emergency collision avoidance systems.
A tiny tot has gone from a tough start in life all the way to preparing for preschool in the space of a few months. Elsa needed a koala whisperer when her mother couldn't produce milk from her at the Australian Reptile Park on the New South Wales Central Coast. The plucky little Joey has thrived and is now ready to meet and mix with other koalas her age.
It's been a hard climb to get this far. Her mother couldn't produce enough milk, so Elsa had to be bottle fed by her keeper, a journey that's been followed globally online. She will now hang out with six kids of her own age before moving into the adult enclosure later this year.
All right, Sam Mack is at the Australian Reptile Park on the New South Wales Central Coast this morning.
We are. Good morning, Sam. Good morning, team. Good morning to our friends here on the Central Coast. Hello.
Hooray!
And great to see our good mate, zookeeper Dan. Dan, great to see you, mate. You're going to take us on a special tour today. But first of all, I have a Tassie Devil here, about 1 year old. You have a young koala. Are they traditionally friends?
No, and that's why I've got it on that shoulder, and you're holding on very tight to our little Tassie Devil.
Tell me about, I want to check in first of all, because I know the fires got quite close to here. I remember chatting to you at the time, you had a lot of plans in place. Thankfully, everything was okay, but you've been helping in other ways through the park here.
Yeah, we were very, very lucky. The fires were only about 8 kilometres as the crow flies, and the amazing work that the RFS did to hold back that fire. We were extremely lucky. We were well prepared, and we had great plans in place. So it was a really, really tense time. A lot of the keepers stayed back for most of the nights because obviously animals come first for us. But yeah, we got away with it. We're pretty lucky.
Well, the plan was to basically put them in the building part because that would have been the safest. But the challenge there is getting animals that don't normally hang out, like maybe a Tassie Devil and a koala, to be so close to each other.
Yeah, it would have been very, very intense. Thankfully, we didn't have to do it. But yeah, we would have got all the animals inside the building and the keepers would have stayed here until we had to. And we would have protected all the animals here in the building, of course.
Now, we've got a lot to talk about across this morning.
Our hero firefighters have had their moment in the spotlight at the Sydney Opera House with photos illuminated onto the sails last night. In a sign of support for fire-ravaged communities, the Opera House displayed a series of pictures taken over the past 3 months. The landmark will also host a comedy fundraiser for the bushfire crisis in March.
Good, well done, lads. Thank you so much for that. And also, we're doing rain dances today. This is shots of Ali not so long ago. Have a look at this, fellas.
This is Ali.
Here we go. Oh, yeah. Yeah, you go, girl. Get it, girl. Get it, girl. Go get it. Yeah, we're back in a moment, folks. Welcome to the Today Show. It's Rain Dance Tuesday. Go, girl.